exhaling joy of heaven to earth come down. Fix in us thy humble dwelling, all thy faithful mercies crown. Jesus, thou art all compassion, pure, unbounded love thou art. Visit us with thy salvation, enter every trembling heart. Finish then thy new creation, pure and spotless let us be. Let us see thy great salvation perfectly restored in thee, changed from glory into glory, till in heaven we take our place, till we cast our crowns before lost in wonder, love, and praise.
And let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, you hold together all things in heaven and on earth. In your great mercy, receive the prayers of all your children, and give to all the world the spirit of your truth and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We're gonna ask you to start one more time. Yeah, turn that one off. Can you hear us on this microphone? He's on a delay.
You can hear me on this?
We'll try again.
We're gonna do this again. The first reading is from the 17th chapter of Acts. Paul stood in front of the Areopagus and said, "Athenians, I see how extremely religious you are in every way. For as I went through the city and looked carefully at the objects of your worship, I found among them an altar with the inscription, 'To an unknown God.' What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you. The God who made the world and everything in it, he who is Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by human hands, nor is he served by human hands as though he needed anything, since he himself gives to all mortals life and breath and all things. From one ancestor he made all nations to inhabit the whole earth, and he allotted the times of their existence and the boundaries of the places where they would live, so that they would search for God and perhaps grope for him and find him, though indeed He is not far from each one of us. For in him we live and move and have our being, as even some of your own poets have said, for we too are his offspring. Since we are God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, an image formed by the art and imagination of mortals. While God has overlooked the times of human ignorance, now he commands all people everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will have the world judged in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed. And of this he has given assurance to all by raising him from the dead. Word of God, word of life.
Bless our God, you peoples, let the sound of praise be heard. Bless our God, you peoples, let the sound of praise be heard. Our God has kept us among the living and has not allowed our feet to slip. Bless our God, you peoples, let the sound of praise be heard. For you, O God, have tested us. You have tried us just as silver has tried. You brought us into the net. You laid heavy burdens upon our backs. You let people ride over our heads. We went through fire and water, but you brought us out into a place of refreshment. I will enter your house with burnt offerings and will pay you my vows, those that I promised with my lips and spoke with my mouth when I was in trouble. I will offer you burnt offerings of fatlings with the smoke of rams. I will give you oxen and goats. Bless our God, you peoples, let the sound of praise be heard. Come and listen, all you who believe, and I will tell you what God has done for me. I called out to God with my mouth and praised the Lord with my tongue. If I had cherished evil in my heart, the Lord would not have heard me. But in truth, God has heard me and has attended to the sound of my prayer. Blessed be God, who has not rejected my prayer, nor withheld unfailing love from me. Bless our God, you peoples, let the sound of praise be heard.
But even if you do suffer for doing what is right, you are blessed. Do not fear what they fear, and do not be intimidated, but in your heart sanctify Christ as Lord. Always be ready to make your defense to anyone who demands from you an accounting for the hope that is in you, yet do it with gentleness and reverence. Keep your conscience clear so that when you are maligned, those who abuse you for your good conduct in Christ may be put to shame. For it is better to suffer for doing good, if suffering should be God's will, than to suffer for doing evil. For Christ also suffered for sins once and all, the righteous for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the spirit, in which also he went and made a proclamation to the spirits in prison, who in former times did not obey, When God waited patiently in the days of Noah during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were saved through water. And baptism, which this prefigured, now saves you, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers made subject to him. Word of God, word of life.
Of eternal life, alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Holy Gospel for this morning comes to us from St. John, the 14th chapter. Jesus said to the disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him because he abides with you and he will be with you. I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me because I live. You also will live. On that day, you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. They who have my commandments and keep them are those who love me. And those who love me will be loved by my Father. And I will love them and reveal myself to them." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. And I invite you to pray first with me. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for the gift of this day. We thank you for waking us up this morning, for giving us air to breathe, for causing our hearts to beat, for giving us everything in this life that we need. Lord, this day, we especially thank you for the gift of your love, your one love that is alive and well in this world. Surround us with that love this morning as we gather around your word. Bless us, enlighten us, enliven us with that love, that we may keep your commandments always. Now I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our rock and our Redeemer. Amen. How do we learn right from wrong? All of us have a longing to know that our way of doing things is the right way of doing things, that our beliefs are the right beliefs. Look, even folks who act in the most awful, corrupt, and destructive ways, when you talk to them and you ask them, "Why did you do what you did?" they tell you they only did what they did because they thought what they were doing was right. Or perhaps Even worse, because they were only following orders. And usually, the friends of those folks will tell you something like that. They just did what they thought was right. It seems that particularly for us living in white America in the 21st century, in this age of social media, everything is permissible. And so whatever we want to do or whatever we want to believe, we can just say whatever we want and post it to Facebook, and then it becomes right. Folks, that's wrong. And we love you. We love you. But if we see you posting dubious and debunked information using cute little propaganda phrases like, I don't know if this is true, but what do you think? We have got to start calling each other out on that. We love you. But if we hear you or see you using truly thoughtless and hateful and unchristian language or images in an effort to make your opinion feel more right or yourself feel more better, bigger, or more in control, for goodness sake, we have got to start calling each other out on that. Hateful speech is still hate speech. Even when it's only a few words. Misinformation you agree with is still misinformation. The privilege of being you does not come with an entitlement to your own facts, no matter how much you disagree with reality or how much reality hurts your feelings. When we have so convinced ourselves that our liberty, which is entrusted to you by God and by the grace of God, by the way, means that we can deny others liberty or justice or truth or God's reality, folks, that's wrong. And we have to do a better job of calling each other out on that. So please, remember, we are a people that pray, thy will be done, not my will and not your will. We are a people that puts God first, not me first. A couple of weeks ago, I watched, as many of us did, the footage of a murder. The ultimate act of selfishness. I watched as two white men hunted down, assaulted, shot, and killed an unarmed black man named Ahmed Aubrey. The killers, they were convinced that what they were doing was right. They had been convinced by our world that no longer sees Jesus, that world that cannot receive the Spirit of truth. They had been convinced they were right. We have pretty much run out of words to describe the sadness and outrage of injustices like this. We have pretty much run out of our emotions as we try to capture the shame and the helplessness we feel with our seeming inability to fight racism within our own borders. We can't take back the evil of that murder. We can't take back the evil we have spoken or the injustice we have tolerated that has led to this world, where the community in which those two white men lived, the law in which they lived, was convinced that they were right. They were right to kill a black man just for exercising while being black. We pray that God will send comfort to to Mr. Aubrey's family, and that God will send a spirit of repentance and understanding into the hearts of his killers and those that support murder. But we don't get to undo that evil. It's a fact. And God calls us, commands us to fight against that wrong, that evil, with everything that we have. How do we teach our children that when God commands, thou shall not kill, that we need to honor and respect that all life is sacred in God's eyes and that black lives matter? That when Jesus commands us to love one another, he's not messing around. Jesus doesn't mean just the ones or the other that agrees with you or looks like you or speaks like you or comes from the same town as you or the same country as you. All of us have a longing to know that we are right. And I think that longing is connected to our need to be loved, to be in a community. We don't want to be alone. We want people to agree with us and share this life with us. But that longing has been so easily twisted and exploited that again and again we are duped into turning toward base tribalism and political divisiveness. It's like a bad drug. It makes you feel good for a little while, but it makes you a slave, and it destroys everything around you. And that's not right. What is right is that there is one love. One love. And it truly unites us all together. There are names for this in every religion, in every country, in every philosophy. We call that God's love or the love of Christ. And I am convinced that our longing to know we are right is directly connected to that longing to know that one love. Siblings in Christ, this is the love and the reality that Jesus Christ has died for and that we are confident in as we look with hope to the resurrection. And Jesus does not call us to say nothing, to do nothing in the face of the forces that work against that one love. No. Jesus calls us to do our part to bring about a world where all people are aware and feel connected to that one love, where all God's children are able to experience the difference God's grace and love in Christ makes in their life and in the life of all creation. And God does not leave us comfortless in this. Jesus tells us with his own words, I'm not leaving you alone. You are not an orphan. My love and the love of the Father are with you always. So when you feel yourself alone, when you're looking to groups of other people who might share your opinion, even if your opinion is wrong, return to that awareness, that faithful understanding that you are never alone, ever. And that we are all of us connected by that one love. Amen. And speaking of love, we're going to sing a song. I'll go over here.
Jesus loves me. This I know, for the Bible tells me so. Well, little ones to him belong. Well, they are weak, but he is strong. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. Well, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves us. Oh, yes, Jesus loves us. Oh, yes, Jesus loves us. The Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me. He will stay close beside me all the way. When at last I come to die, he will take me home on high. Yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me.
Tells you too.
So.
Amen.
Amen. Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Abiding God, you have revealed yourself to us in the form of your Son, Jesus Christ. Embolden your church as your followers to reveal your love to everyone in our speaking and in our living. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You are the creator of heaven and earth. Revitalize the health of oceans, rivers, lakes, springs, glaciers, and other bodies of water that give life to your creatures. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You call all people of the world your children. Judge the nations justly, show mercy to the oppressed, and speak truth to power through your prophets. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You come near to us when we are lost, and you hear our distress. We pray for those who suffer in any way during these difficult times. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your commands are good and merciful. Give us courage to take hold of our baptismal promises, to work for justice, advocate for the voiceless, and free the oppressed and imprisoned in body, mind, or spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You remain with us always, O God, and your kingdom has no end. We remember the saints who have gone before us. Unite us forever in your final victory over death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, we ask that you hear us as we pray the words that you have taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And I'm going to quick go through the announcements since I understand you did not hear me. So good morning, everyone. On behalf of all the guys who have joined me, thank you for being with us. As we consider to think what in-person worship is going to be looking like, we will be holding a series of listening posts beginning next Sunday after worship, with three during the week, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and ending on the 31st, Pentecost Sunday, after worship. We invite you to join in the conversation that will provide a vision for what ministry is going to look like at St. John's in the days ahead, and we ask that you would sign up for one of those conversations. Also, because the need is still great, we are holding a second drive-through food drive to help our local pantry keep supplied and ready to serve anyone who's in need. We will collect food and monetary donations for Feed More Western New York from 10 a.m. until 1 p.m. on Saturday, May 30th in the church parking lot. And please see the St. John's Times, which is our weekly newsletter, for more information about what items are needed. And of course, after this service, please join us for a virtual coffee hour on Zoom. And so now, go with God's blessing. May the one who brought forth Jesus from the dead raise you to new life, fill you with hope, and turn your mourning into dancing. And may Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen.
The power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger, the King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder and leaves us breathless in awe and wonder, the King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Whoa, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory. Who rules the nations with truth and justice? Shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life. That I would be set free. Whoa, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy, worthy. Oh, this is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. that you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.